It's Laura Eubanks of Design for Serenity with the grand reveal in Mount Helix, California. And I'm standing here with my girl, Quan Li. She is a goddess of enlightenment. Just, I don't know, being enlightened. This has been the most amazing installation. It has been seamless. It has flowed. We're absolutely thrilled with the outcome on this particular project. Let's go through and take a look, shall we? Remember, this is a rectangular terrace, and the property extends down below into the pool area and the art studio. And then there's an additional level and an orchard below that. So this property sits on three levels. This was great because I didn't have to worry about privacy. I didn't have to worry about blocking any views. The views here are panoramic and spectacular. So I went with low level plantings all the way through. And you know what I always tell you about ones, threes, and fives. So my first thought was I want to have either one, three, or five vignettes of plants. However it works out. The property, this terrace is narrow at one end and it widens and then turns into an L over here at the back. So the clients spend a lot of time out in the studio and they are up and down these stairs constantly all day, every day. So when we were bringing in soil and working on the mounding and figuring out where our pathways were going to go, we were also spying on our clients, watching them walk back and forth to get a sense of how they did it so that we could mirror the flagstone path to accommodate their natural flow of traffic. Remember also what I tell you about gardens need to be lived in. Always remember to add pathways, add trails, add destinations. You want to draw your friends into the garden. Gardens are a gift and they need to be experienced this way, not from over at the edge. We brought some elements into the garden. We've got our tipped pot. And remember what I always say too, that the golden rule of design, first and foremost, is it needs to make sense. So if you have a tipped pot, you've got to have something spilling out of it, otherwise it doesn't make sense. So we've got some Senecio raulianus, or string of pearls, and a little pad of Daimondia with some little succulent cuttings just set on top. And those will eventually root right into the soil and grow. Here we have a Buddha, which we found in another area of the yard, and I staged him next to these Echeveria agavioides. These look like lotus flowers, and I thought this was a perfect vignette. Most of you that have followed me know about my love of Criva, C-R-I-V-A, that white crushed marble, and the fire glass that I like to decorate with sometimes. Greg put a application of Wet Look 2000, that permeable lacquer that sets it all in place, puts a crust on it so it won't move or be disturbed by wind, rain, or errant animals. Here's one of our big succulent tapestry islands. Credit goes to Melanie Huff, my design assistant, for laying in this tapestry. It's stunning. Thank you, Mel. Over here, we've staged our goddess, Quan Li. Our focal point is the Aloe Hercules. Now, you'll notice that in the garden, he is just left of center. You don't want to ever do anything spot on, always slightly left or right. Greg and the guys created a couple of little patios. And here's the tapestry, the other vignette tapestry that was installed by my daughter, Hannah Eubanks, who does most of my videos. She did some tapestry work here. And we have our dragon, our sea serpent, staged in this area. Then I've got some specimen aloes, smaller ones. I've got an agaves. I've got agave blood spot. I've got Kisho Khan. I have a cream spike over on the other side. Now, all in all, there's probably at least 50 varieties of plants in this garden. This has been Laura Eubanks of Design for Serenity with the grand reveal in Mount Helix, California, and your